Hey there, welcome to a step-by-step tutorial on how to install PyCharm, which is one of the best and well-known IDEs of Python programming language. So let's go. So the first step is to search for PyCharm download in Google, and then you will see this link, I mean jetbrains.com, and we have a PyCharm of this JetBrains company, so we should click on this link. So here is PyCharm website, and you can see that we have two options, the professional option and the community option. But we want to install the community. Why? Because it's free. Because it's free, we want to use this community edition. An important note, if your Windows is a 32-bit Windows, then you shouldn't download this link because this link is not going to work for you. If your Windows is a 32-bit Windows, then you should go here and click on this other versions and open this link in a new tab. So you should download other versions. Why? Because this is not going to work for you. So again, I repeat, if your Windows is a 32-bit Windows, you shouldn't download this one. But if your Windows is a 64-bit Windows, then you can skip this part and go to the remaining parts. So for those people who have 32-bit Windows, they should scroll down to version 2018, and you can see here it is, and you should download this one. The other versions, I mean the newer versions, will not work for you. So if you have a 32-bit Windows, then you should install this version, I mean version 2018. So here we have two editions, the professional edition and the community edition. But remember that the community edition is free. So here you should download this link. You should download this link. So again, if you have a 32-bit Windows, you should download this link, not newer versions. But for those people who have 64-bit Windows, they should click on this one. They should click on this link and wait for the downloading of the PyCharm. You shouldn't do anything. So there it is, and here we want to choose the path that we want to download this file. So for example, I want to download and save this file in my G drive, so I press save. So now the download has finished, and we want to show this file in its folder. So in order to install PyCharm, we should double click on this one in PyCharm community that we have downloaded. So we double click on this and we press run. In this step, we should press the next button, and here we should choose the path that we want to install PyCharm. So here we don't want to change the direction, I mean the destination folder, because it is going to install this PyCharm on C drive and program files, JetBrains PyCharm community, and there it is. So we press this next button, and here I don't want to check none of these. If you want to check any of these, you can, but I don't want to check none of these. So I press the next button, and here I click the install button. And you and I should wait for the installation process. So now it has finished. So we check this one, I mean run PyCharm community edition, and we click this finish button. And again, we should wait. So here PyCharm asks if I want to import anything, but I don't want to import anything. So I say do not import settings. So I press OK. And again, we should wait again. So here I click this one, I mean new project. So here I should choose a location for my project. For example, I want to choose the location to be C drive and users, Kulak, PyCharm project. And I want to choose a name, for example, let's say YouTube for this project. If you have watched my previous video on how to install Python on Windows 10, then you can remember that we have installed Python on my G drive and in a folder called Python 3.9. So I open this folder and you can see that there it is. Here's our interpreter. This python.exe is our Python interpreter. So we need this path, I mean, we need this file in order to add an interpreter to PyCharm. So let's do it. You should check this one, I mean previously configured interpreter, and here you should click on this three dots button, and here again you should choose your interpreter, but you should click on this three dots again. So here I choose my G drive and I go to Python 3.9, and here is my Python. So I choose python.exe, which is the interpreter of my Python. So I press OK button, and here again I click this OK button and I uncheck this one, because if I check this one, it creates a main.py, I mean a new Python file, which I don't want that. So I uncheck this one and I click this create button. And here is the PyCharm tips, which I want to check this one, I mean don't show tips. And I press this close button. And we should wait for these processes. So it has been finished, but to be honest, I don't like this dark theme, so I want to change it to a light one. So I go to File, then Settings, and here in the Appearance, I mean the Appearance and Behavior, and then Appearance part, I want to change the theme to a light one. So I press OK, and you can see that here is a light theme. As I said, I prefer the light theme. But what is your opinion? Do you like the dark theme or the light theme? Tell us about it in the comments below. So in order to create a Python file, I should right click on my project. I mean YouTube, and right click. Then I go to new Python file and I name the file, for example, code, let's say 01, and I press enter. And then you can see that there it is. Here's a Python code. So I want to type print, so I type PR, and you can see the perfect and awesome auto completion of this PyCharm. And I press the tab button on my keyboard and there it is. And for example, I can type, let's say YouTube, and you should right click on this code. You should right click on this code and you should press this one, I mean run code 01. If you press this one, then you can see that there it is. Here is the output of this code. If you want to change the font size, then you should go to File, then Settings, and here you should go to the Editor section, and here you should go to Font, and here you can change the font size. For example, I want to set it to 24, let's say, and I press this OK button, and here it is. The font size has been changed. So again, maybe you want to change the font family, so you go to File, Settings, and here in the editor part and the font section, for example, maybe you want to change the font to this one. And if I press the OK button, you can see that there it is. If you want to create a new code, you can right click on this one, or you can right click on this one. I mean, you can right click on this one or on the project name and press new and Python file. And for example, you choose a name, let's say code 02 or whatever name you want. And I press enter, and you can see that there it is. Here's another code. And for example, I want to print something. For example, I want to print code 02. And if I run right click and run code 2, you can see that there it is. Here's the code 2. And remember, you can change the order of these codes. And maybe you want to delete a code. For example, maybe I want to delete this code. So I right click on it and then I press delete. And there it is. I uncheck these ones because I don't want a safe mode. So I press OK button. And there it is. The code 2 has been deleted. And you can close this panel by clicking this project panel, and you can see that it has been hidden. But if you click on it again, you can see that a panel has been shown. So it's like a toggle button. For example, when you click on it, it will be hide. If you click on it again, it will be shown. And again, if I want to run this code, I should right click on this page and run code 01. I mean the name of that code. And if I run it, you can see that here's the output, and I can minimize the output or the run window. And if you need this run window, you can click on this one and there it is. Here's the run window. But if you want, you can minimize it, and you can also minimize this panel. There it is. So if someone asks you where is the interpreter of your PyCharm, then you should go to File, Settings, and here, for example, I close this editor section and I go to this part, I mean project, and this is the name of our project. And I go to this one, Python interpreter, and you can see that this is the interpreter of our PyCharm. So you can see the interpreter of my PyCharm is on G drive in a folder called Python 3.9, and the interpreter is python.exe. I can change it. For example, I can click on this and I can show all the interpreters, or if I want to add a new interpreter, I can add like this. I can press the plus button. So I can add an existing interpreter by clicking this one. I mean existing environment. And I click on this three dots. And here I will choose the location of my interpreter and then I press OK. But I don't want to choose another interpreter, so I click cancel and again I click cancel and I again click cancel. There it is. And again I click cancel. There it is. Here's how to install PyCharm on Windows 10. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe and click the bell next to it to be notified of every new video. And remember, we are going to continue this series of Python tutorials. So please don't forget to subscribe. See you on next video.